Now? Okay, sorry. So this is just about the SaltStack developer community. So all of you know about the SaltStack, right? That's a configuration management and remote execution orchestration tool. And so first, I just want to know how many of you are coming from a developer background. Can you just raise your hand just to understand? Yeah. Yeah, at least half of you guys are from developer background. And how many of you contributed to any free or open source projects? Yeah, at least a bunch of you guys contributed. That's good. So this tool is something that is going to be, you know, interesting for you folks, those who contributed to free or open source softwares. And, you know, yeah, so I also done a little bit contributions, not too many. I think around 68 commits, and that too, it's in 2012. So that means I am no more such an active contributor to SaltStack that I've done 2 years before, okay? So one of the thing is that this, I hope you guys heard about the term called open source versus open core. Many of, when you're picking up a you know, good development community, I think you should see whether that's really working in the free or open source culture also. It's, but there are some other companies which actually works in the way of open core technology, okay? You, of course, you can Google search and find out, you know, whether the your favorite whatever this configuration management tools are really open source or free open source, or is it just open core, okay? And so SaltStack is something really free or open source software, and it's the community, everything is developed in the same way. And it's a very active development community. Maybe if you check the octoverse.github.com, I've taken a picture here. You can see that this one of the community highlights, if you look at this, most projects with most merged pull request and repositories with most issued closed. You can see that SaltStack is coming as the third largest project in the GitHub, which is the, and in 2012 also, that was the eighth you know, most active project in GitHub. And if you look at this, I made some comparison with the OAuth, which is a statistics, you know, a provider where you can compare with Salt. I kept Puppet, Ansible. Maybe this Ansible and Puppet is having almost same kind of activity. But if you look at the compared with the Puppet, you can see the number of developers. It's almost a less number, maybe half, less than half of the developers, and number of commits, everything. Even though SaltStack is like a 3 year project, whereas you know, Puppet is like a 9 year old project. So we can check this OAuth statistics. And it's a very receptive community. So all the pull requests that you send to that GitHub is, will get some review. You can definitely go and check this. I'm making this comparison with similar things like Puppet or Ansible, just to get an idea. You can go to Ansible or Puppet GitHub repositories and check the pull request and see how much people are commenting on your pull request that is sent to that one, and how many of them are closing without even any comments. And you can check the same thing in SaltStack repository also, and see there won't be any single pull request which there is no discussion going on. And you will not see too many pull requests hanging around there for so many 6 months or 1 year like that. Okay, and it's a very active mailing list and IRC channels you'll see there. And there are a lot of awards also that are received by SaltStack. You can go to this saltstack.com awards space. You can see that receive the cool vendor from the, you know, award from the Gartner, and many other this kind of GitHub ranking, all the things you can see here. Okay, so what I was trying to tell you is that if you're picking up, if you want to contribute to such a amazing, of course, this is a Python-based one, so if you are a Python developer especially, and if you want to contribute to such a great community, this would be a good project where you can look into this for contribution. Okay, that's all.